San Francisco State University Finance 372, Take 10, Team 10 in action.
All right, hi guys, I'm John Stanza.
I'm Andrew Singh.
Ben Kumar.
Christine Ham.
And today we are presenting on an Essex Property Trust, and we're recommending a sell based on an intrinsic value of 241 below the current price of 250. So today we're going to go over a brief background and talk about the leadership as well as the organizational structure and the services and products Essex provide. Then we're going to do a different analysis. We're going to do geographical, SWOT, and financial. Finally, we're going to show you how we value the stock and then make some recommendations. So I'm going to give it over to Christy to talk about the background.
So Essex was founded in 1971 by George Marcus. Their headquarters are located in Palo Alto. They are a fully integrated REIT that acquire, develop, redevelop, and manage multifamily apartments. Their portfolio is concentrated in Northern California, Southern California, and in Seattle, Washington. They have partnered with local communities to participate in energy efficiency and water conservation. And in 2011 and 2015, they received two awards for their environmentally responsible buildings.
For leadership, the president is Michael J. Scholl. The vice president is Angela L. Kleiman, and the co-chief investment officer is John D. Udy. And as for the organizational structure, Essex apartment communities are situated in prime locations along the West Coast and Oregon. Their core values are sustainability, teamwork, and accountability. Their strategy is to collaborate with customers to achieve operational efficiencies, reduce environmental impacts, and improve communities. They also expand business intelligence, unified and adaptive community culture, maintain strong balance sheet and financial flexibility.
Their services and products include 239 communities and over 57,000 apartments in both California and Washington. They have over 1,700 employees. In 2014, they implemented about 225 sustainable projects in their communities, and they're constantly adding new ways to renew energy. Here's a geographical analysis of their apartments. There's 48% of their apartments are located in Southern California, 31% in San Francisco, and 21% in Seattle, Washington.
For the SWOT analysis, their strengths are existing distribution networks and high sales growth rate. Their weaknesses are high loan rates, too much competition, low profitability, low investments in research and development. Their opportunities are income level is at a constant increase in growth rates. Their threats are technological problems, increase in labor costs, and the rising cost of raw materials, as well as high competition.
All right, so in comparison with their competitors, they're about the third-ranked apartment REIT below Avalon Bay and Equity Residential, and they have a market capitalization of about $16.4 billion. In terms of financial ratios, their ROA is pretty exactly consistent really with the industry average, so we gave them an average. In terms of ROE, they're a bit below average, or a lot below average. Same with the PE ratio, so we gave them a below average. Their dividend yield is also below average, but their dividend payout is actually above the industry average, so we gave them good for an overall ranking of average. And then their EPS is much above the industry average, which is very good. Their FFO multiple is also a little bit above the industry average, as well as their debt-to-equity ratio is below, so we give them below average. Their debt-to-total market cap is 48.3%, which is above the 32% industry average for very good. And their cash flow to debt is also 12.1% above the 5.6% industry average, which we also rank very good for an overall quality of good. For the technical analysis, we had their support line coming in at about $223.15 with the resistance line around 240, but they managed to break through that to their current price of about 250 now.
So for the DCF, we got a weighted debt of 46%, a weighted equity of 54%, and a WACC of 6%. Our total value was $220 with an intrinsic value of 236. We decided to go with 8%, which gave us a REIT value of $236, which is currently under the stock price of $250 at a discount of 5%. Our perpetuity model, we decided to go with a 5% at $246. Our FFO we used was 12.33, which was 2018, which gave us also an intrinsic value of $246, which is under the stock price of $250 at a discount of 1%. Our GOR and GROWT, we decided to go with our beta was, our expected market return was 9%, with a rate of 6.5. We decided to go with a rate of 6% at 246, which also gave us an intrinsic value of 246, which was also under the current stock price at a discount of 1%. Our multiple approach, we decided to go with 19, 22, and 20, and at an FFO of $12.33. We like the multiple of 20, which gave us a value of 246, which is also under the current stock price at a discount of 1%. And then with our net asset value, we got an NOI of $512 million with 66 million shares outstanding. We went with the cap rate of 6%, would give us NAV of $259 with a premium of 3.6%.
So when we weighted it, we decided to go with the final scenario there, which gave us an intrinsic value of about $241.80 below the $250 current price for a discount of 3%. So as such, we recommend to sell, and our trades are for REITs are to sell short, write calls and buy puts, for ETF to sell short, write calls and buy puts, and for the indexes to write forwards, write futures, write calls on futures, and buy calls on futures. And here are our references.